Hi, hello, welcome back to my channel Twitter Things. Today in this video we are going to see a simple Angular example using Stackblitz, that is to-do list. How to create a to-do list in Angular application we are going to see. So I am using the Stackblitz website, stackblitz.com, where you can create any JS environment within milliseconds. For practicing purpose, I have been using this website from few more months. So I recommend you to use the same, because it will reduce your time by, it will not take much time to download all the dependencies, like how you are doing in your local machine. So you can just simply by clicking, you will get your Angular environment here. So you will have default as a 15th version at present. I am having that. You can remove that boilerplate which you are getting. So by default, it will give app component as a default component. You can just remove the HTML kind of thing, so that you will, the changes how you are doing, so that the resultant output will come in this window. So first thing I want to add Bootstrap. Without Bootstrap, any website will not look that much good. So I'm just adding Bootstrap. Here in the dependencies, we have to enter the package which you want and just click on enter, so that it will install the dependencies. The missing dependencies, it will ask you to install them, and you have to install them also. So once that is installed, the one more thing which you have to do is you have to import that in whatever the install Bootstrap kind of thing into your application, so that can used in all the components. So installation is completed. You have to import in this file, that is tiles.css file. Here in this file you have to import, and the path you have to mention correctly, so that will attach it correctly, otherwise it won't get attached. The name should also be correct. So Bootstrap, this slash you have to use Bootstrap and dist dot css thing, and after Bootstrap dot min dot css, this is a file which you have to import in this application. So once it is correct, the errors which you are getting here will not come. So if anything is wrong, these errors will come. So now error has gone, that imported Bootstrap kind of thing in this Stackblitz application, so that now we can create any changes and we can make any changes to this. So first thing which I want to add is a header for my application. So what I want to add as a header is this. What is this app? It's to-do list, right? I want to add to-do list in Angular. I'm just doing that. So I can add some classes also now, as I have added Bootstrap kind of thing. I want to add BG color, background color for this as info. And also I want to add one thing, that is this text center kind of thing, so that I get the text in center. So now it is fine, right? So the header I have added, and what I want to do is for to-do list, I have to enter first inputs. So for that part, I want to create one input box, likewise those kind of things. So for that, I am taking one card kind of thing. So class is equal to Bootstrap, we have card kind of thing. So in card, what I want to take is, first I want to take as a input box, which is having as a type as whatever we are giving is text, right? So type as text, and I want to give some placeholder for that box instead of a label, to understand what kind of data you have to enter your task here. I want to give this text as in a, here you can see, enter your text here, task here as an input box. So this is fine, right? So now I want to give one more what it called as a TypeScript, so template reference variable, which we can use in Angular, that is as a name of this text box, that is task I have given. So this is fine, up to inbox is fine. So next to that inbox, what I want to give is, I want to give one breakpoint, and after that I want to give one button. So whatever you have added, you have to submit that, right? So I want to add is add task. So add task to the list. So add task to the list I have given as a button text. So whatever the things I want to add for this button, I can add. I want to add class, which is of button type, and I want button color as success. So okay, now I got a button. And one more thing which I want to do for this button is, I want to add some method for this, like on click. What I want to do is, add task is a method I want to call. So now add task is not present, so it will throw an error. So after adding whatever the kind of thing you have to do is, you have to add just method here in the TS file. So now it is fine. It will not throw any error. So now we have input box and the add button for this. Everything looks great. So one more thing I want to add here is styling for this card. I want to add width of this card. So for width, I'm taking 25 rem width. You can see this is the width of the card. So now fine. One more thing which I want to do in this is, next thing I want to list of the items, right? So on the add, what we are doing for this add, so we are doing nothing on add. What we have to do is we have to add to our list. We have should have one list first of all. So task list, what I want in the task list is which is of any type. So just or any type, or you can just give a string array, it's empty array, which is an default and empty array string array. So for this I have to add the task which I have entered. So on add, so first of all, this dot task list dot, for this kind of operation we have push to add item in that, right? So we have to add some task here. So whatever that task we are passing to this method, that is a add task. So here we are not passing anything. What we have to pass is the input which I have submitted here in this box. We have to pass dot value, we have to pass, not an entire template value we have to pass. So now it is fine. So value we are passing and pushing that into the list. So this is fine. So whatever, one more thing what we have to do is, whatever the list we are adding, I want to display the thing also. So for that, we have to use the TS variable, that is a string array here in this HTML file. So for that, I want to take one span element. So in which I want to give some text like my tasks. My task after some horizontal line, after that I want to, what I want to add is some divs I want to add, in which we have this ng4. ng4 is equal to let any item in which off from this task list I have to iterate. So I have to print them task, whatever the task we have, that is item only. So this is a string array, so we have to give the index of that item. So for that we have to add one more thing, that is here. So after iterating we have to add let I is equal to index. I have defined like I, so now here item of I, then that will come here. So item of I is fine, index of I. If you want the numbering for the task also, what you can add here is I is the numbering. So I will be start from 0 index, so I plus 1 you can give like this. And this is the task description, you can add give dash for that. So after this listing of tasks, what I want to do is I want to have a delete button for that also. So I can just take this whatever the button which already we have, so I can add the same here button kind of thing. So button I have added, but here we have to delete button. And the danger color I have to give, that is red color. And the method also, the name will change, that is task delete task method. The passing parameter also same, we have to pass that index is enough, like I we can pass. So now delete method is not present here, so that we can add the public type and we can give name here. So on delete method, what we have to perform is we have to perform like okay, we can close this. What we have to do in this is we have to remove that particular indexed element. We are passing data here, right? Index we are passing. So based upon that index, we have to delete that element from that. So for that, we have splice one method. So where we have to specify that index from where to how many elements we are removing, like one element from there. So this is the thing which we have to write for delete. So this is fine right now. Everything is fine. Let's see how it will look like. So now everything is fine. BG color and card, which is of width this much. No padding, such kind of thing. We can add padding thing also. So padding of 20 pixel, now we can see it is fine. We can add margin for this also. Margin of 10 pixel. Now it is looking great, right? Margin after padding margin, you can see enter the task is there, add task to the list. And here you can just give some breakpoint to this. So that will look great. So now enter the task to a list. Here you will get the list of items. So let's see whether that will work or not. So I'm just adding like sleep task. Here you can see. So what is happening is, okay, it is getting a string of elements. That is first element you are getting. Here it is fine, right? Like that. It is string error and getting strings. Sleep. Okay, task 1, task 2, likewise. So it is fine. You can give some gap here. Okay, now every time when you make changes, it will take hot reloading so that you are not getting results every time. So now everything is done right. We can also like log console kind of thing, how the application is changing like this. So you can add any task. One is sleep, I can add. So here you are again having data. Whenever you enter, it's not removing from here. For that purpose, what we can do is, after adding here, what you can do is you can remove the value from that particular thing. That is the task, whatever the template we are having, the task dot value is equal to, you can set as empty, so that whenever you add one thing, so whenever you click on add, after this the data present in this input box will vanish and comes as empty likewise. So whenever you delete this, this item will be deleted likewise. You can add any item. So eat will be the first task yours, and after eat you have to sleep. And this is clumsy, so that what we can do is we can add just a break here. Break point I have added. So again, once we can see the outputs, so eat, sleep, to do task likewise, you can add cook, next work, likewise we can add. So this is all about to-do list, simple to-do list in Angular. You can delete this task or randomly you can delete any task, so it will give the numbering. So see, whenever you given after next time, it will give numbering. Whenever you delete first task, it will give the work as a first task, it will update likewise. So this is all about to-do list. I hope you understood. This is a simple example where you are using template reference variable as task and passing that as a add field, and for deleting we are passing as index number of that array. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give a big thumbs up below and share this video to your friends and colleagues who are at learning stage of web development things. We have done so many tutorials in Angular concepts. Check out my playlist so that you will get concept better. I have explained everything with an example using the Stackblitz website. Share this video to your friends and subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.